Okay, students. Now let us discuss one more application in case of really foreign word. So application in case of really foreign word. So another application, the most important application in case of really foreign bodies, application number one. So already in yesterday class we discussed some applications. So this is another one application in case of really foreign bodies. So a body is dropped from the top of the tower. It reaches the time T1. Height of the tower is h. Height of the tower is, of course, h1. So a body is released from the top of the tower. A body is released from the multi-story tower. It reaches the ground by a time t1. h1 is the height of the tower. Now a body is released from the top of the tower like this. It will be stopped at some distance. That is nothing but h2. That is nothing but h2. It travel by a time t2. It travel by a time what? T2. Then after again immediately released. So the remaining distance covered by t3. Covered by the body in a time interval T3. So the distance of remaining is, that is H3. So in this case calculate the value of T3. The value of T3. So T3 is the time taken by the body to cover the distance of H3. Okay. So dear students, so let us consider tower. దాని హైట్ వచ్చి h1. ఒక బాడీ మనం పైనుంచి కిందకి రిలీజ్ చేస్తే ఎంత టైం తీసుకుంటుందన్నా t1 తీసుకుంటుంది జనరల్ గా. అయితే ఆ బాడీని టాప్ ఆఫ్ ద టవర్ నుంచి రిలీజ్ చేశారు. సో అయితే అది h2 డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ అయిన తర్వాత ఆఫ్ చేశారు. జస్ట్ ఇట్ విల్ బి స్టాప్డ్ బై ట్రావెలింగ్ డిస్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ h2. ఇన్ దిస్ కేస్ వాట్ ఇస్ ద టైం t2. దెన్ ఆఫ్టర్ ఇమీడియట్లీ రిలీజ్. Of course, the gap is very fractional, neglected time interval. So then immediately released. So it covered by a distance of h3 in a time interval t3. What is the value of t3? What is the value of t3 in this case? Okay, now so let us start. In this case, see. So we know. H1 is equal to, it is clearly H2 plus H3. Total height is equal to sum of the individual heights, H2 plus H3. So what is the value of H1 in case of freely falling bodies using like this ut plus of gt square? By using this equation, so what is the value of H? Initial, of course, freely falling bodies, initially what is the velocity now? Initial velocity what? 0. So 0 plus half gt square. So h is equal to what? Half gt square. This is the height of the body in case of freely falling bodies. This is the height of the tower in case of freely falling bodies. Okay. By using this equation, h1 is what? Half g t1 square is equal to half g t2 square plus half g T3 square. Okay, students. H2. So follow the body initial velocity 0. ఇక్కడ కూడా నో H3 also ఇక్కడ నుంచి కూడా మళ్ళీ డ్రా రిలీజ్ అయింది కాబట్టి దాని ఇనిషియల్ వెలాసిటీ కూడా 0. ఓకే 1/2g గెట్ క్యాన్సిల్ అవుట్. దెన్ T1 స్క్వేర్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు T2 స్క్వేర్ ప్లస్ T3 స్క్వేర్. సో T3 స్క్వేర్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు T1 స్క్వేర్ మైనస్ T2 స్క్వేర్. T3 is equal to square root of T1 square minus T2 square. By using this formula to calculate the time t3. Okay students, this is the important application. Of course, almost last application in case of free-defining voids. Okay, so dear students, I will explain once again. This is the tower height h1. One body on tower point release t1 time lo ground reach ayindi. Aithe ikkada two cases ichadu. Adhe body release chesinappudu, so it travel by distance of h2, it will be stopped. Okay, dani t2 time iskundi. Tarvata once again immediately it released. So it reaches the ground by a time of t3, cover by distance of h3. So calculate the value of t3. Calculate the time value of t3 like this. H1 is equal to h2 plus total height is equal to sum of the individual heights. H2 plus h3. Okay, by using this, then finally you t3 is equal to square root of t1 square minus t2 square. Okay students, this is the very most important application in case of freely falling bodies. Now let us discuss. So vertically projected bodies. Vertically projected bodies. So in case of vertical projected bodies, a body is projected vertically upwards like this. So initial velocity u, see, a is equal to minus z, that is the body moving against gravity, then acceleration is nothing but minus z. Okay, a is equal to minus z. So in case of vertically projected bodies, so what are the equations, that is equations of motions, how to change the equations of motions. So vertically projected bodies like this, in case of vertically projected bodies, equations of linear motion changes by like this. First equation, v is equal to u plus actually ad, v is equal to u minus gt, a is equal to minus z. Next, second one, s is equal to ut plus half gt square. S is equal to what? H, maximum height of the body, of course. So then h is equal to ut minus half gt square. See, g is equal, a is equal to what? This is at square. So a is equal to what? Minus z. Next, third application. So v square is equal to u square plus 2gs. Of course, v square is equal to u square minus 2gh. Of course, at maximum height, final velocity will be zero, no doubt. This is the height of the body at any instant of time. It is not a maximum height, height of the body at any instant of time. So at that time interval, corresponding velocity, final velocity, v square is equal to u square minus 2dh. Next one, fourth one, Sm is equal to generally distance of, that is distance traveled by the body in nth second of motion. Sm is equal to u plus a by 2 into 2n minus 1. It is changed by hn is equal to u minus g by 2 into 2n minus 1. Okay, so these are the equations of motion in case of vertically projected bodies. Okay students, now one application. First application, in case of vertically projected bodies, so calculate the maximum height h. Suppose let us consider a body projected vertically upwards with a velocity of what? V be the velocity of the body. A is equal to what? Minus g. S is equal to h. This is the maximum height.
at maximum height final velocity will be zero. Then using the equation of motion, so dear students, using the equation of motion, using v square is equal to u square plus 2gs, then it will changes to v square is nothing but final velocity at maximum height. 0 is equal to u square minus 2g. Of course, this is a 2as. A is nothing but minus g. S is nothing but h. This is the maximum. Maximum height. So now 2gh is equal to u square. H is equal to what? U square by 2g. This is the maximum height of the body in case of this is the maximum height of the vertically projected bodies. Vertically projected bodies. So important formula. H is equal to u square by 2g. Now next one. Next application to how to calculate the time of ascent. Time of ascent is nothing but TA, represented by letter TA. Time of ascent means time taken by the body to reach the maximum height from projection. After projection, time taken by the body to reach the maximum height is called time of ascent. So time of ascent means time taken by the body to reach the maximum height after projection. So the body is projected in the maximum height. వెళ్ళడానికి ఎంత టైం తీసుకుందో దాన్ని మనం టైమ్ ఆఫ్ అసెంట్ అంటాం. సో మాక్సిమం వెలాసిటీ విల్ బి జీరో, ఫైనల్ వెలాసిటీ విల్ బి జీరో, యు బి ద ఇనిషియల్ వెలాసిటీ. ఓకే, సో దెన్ టైమ్ ఆఫ్ అసెంట్ యూజింగ్ ద ఈక్వేషన్ ఆఫ్ మోషన్, హౌ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ ద టైమ్ ఆఫ్ అసెంట్, వి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు యూ ప్లస్ ఏటి. బై యూజింగ్ దిస్ ఫార్ములా దెన్ వి క్యాలిక్యులేట్ ద టైమ్ ఆఫ్ అసెంట్. సో ఫైనల్ వెలాసిటీ విల్ బి జీరో, ఇనిషియల్ వెలాసిటీ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ యూ, ఏ ఇస్ నథింగ్ బట్ జి minus g, that is TA. So g TA is equal to u, TA is equal to u by g. This is the time of ascent. That is the time of ascent. Okay, now the next one, time of descent. Time of descent. Time of descent. So time of descent means TD, that is the time of descent. So time of descent means time taken by the body to reach the ground, to reach the ground from maximum height, from that is called time of descent. Maximum height inka ground reach avadaniki patte time e time of descent. Time of descent already we studied in regular classes. Time of ascent is nothing but time of descent. So that is TD is nothing but TA, that is equal to what? U by G. Time of ascent equal to time of descent. Okay, next one, that is application number 4. So next one, time of flight. Time of flight, the probability letter capital T. Time of flight is nothing but sum of time of ascent plus time of descent. Sum of time of descent plus, that is sum of time of descent and that is time of ascent is nothing but time of flight. Or time of flight is nothing but time taken by the body to reach the ground after projection, that is called time of flight. So both definitions are same. Time of flight means sum of the time of descent and time of ascent is nothing but time of flight, or time taken by the body to reach the ground after projection. So suppose ikkada nunchi nenu project chesina body ni ikkada daaka time of ascent, ikkada nunchi ikkadiki vachedariki malli time of, this is the time of ascent, this is the time of descent, total time what? Time of flight. So that is nothing but both are equal kabatti 2TA. Time of flight is equal to 2 into what is the value of TA? U by G. This is the time of flight. Time of flight.
So in case of vertically projected bodies. Next one. Next one. So next application. Next application. Suppose the body is projected vertically upwards. Velocity at the half of the maximum height. So velocity at the half of the maximum height. Half of the maximum height. So what is the velocity of the body at the half of the maximum height? So whenever the body is projected vertically upwards, what is the velocity of the body at half of the maximum height reach? Okay, so in this case, dear students, S is equal to H is equal to what? Maximum height, half of the maximum height. I will take half of the maximum height, that is half maximum height u square by 2g. This is the H. So for example, this is the maximum height, this is half, that is h by 2. So in this region, what is the velocity of the projected body? What is the velocity of projected body? Okay, so using the equation of motion, v square is equal to u square plus 2as, then v square is equal to u square minus 2 into, what is the value of a g into s? What is the value of s? At half of the maximum height, s is equal to what? 1 by 2 into u square by 2g. So 2g cancel out. V square is equal to u square minus u square by 2. This is suppose simply 1 minus 1 by 2 is nothing but 1 by 2. That is u square by 2. V is equal to what? V by root 2. So dear students, this is the velocity of the body at a half of the maximum height. Half of the maximum height. This is the important application. Suppose, for example, one problem. I will take one problem. A body is projected vertically upwards with a velocity of, suppose, 20 meter per second. What is the final velocity of the body at the half of the maximum height? Half of the maximum height. Then final velocity of the body at half of the maximum height. What is the formula? U by root 2. What is the value of u? That is 20 by root 2. So 20 is nothing but 2 into 10 is divided by root 2. Simply 2 is nothing but root 2 into 10 divided by root 2 get cancelled out. Then v is equal to what? 1.4 and 4 into 10. That is 14.14 meter per second. Okay, so this is the velocity of the body at the half of the maximum height. So it is a simple formula. Okay, students. Now next one. So what is the velocity of the body? Next one. What is the velocity of the body at the 3/4 of maximum height? 3/4 of maximum height. So next application, like this. So what is the velocity? Whenever the body is projected vertically upwards, what is the velocity of the body at the 3/4 of maximum height? 3/4 of maximum height. Okay, students. Then in this case, S is equal to what? H is equal to 3/4 of maximum height. That is u square by 2g. Then again, I will take same formula. V square is equal to u square plus 2as. V square is equal to u square minus 2a is nothing but minus g. That is g minus g. S is nothing but what? 3/4 u square by 2g. Okay. Then 2g get cancelled out. So v square is equal to u square minus 3u square by 4. So LCM what? 4. 4u square minus 3u square. 4u square minus 3u square, that is u square by 4. Is nothing but v is equal to what? Square root, that is u by 2. So dear students, whenever the body reaching the height of 3 by 4th of maximum height, velocity of the body is reduced by half of the projected velocity. Half of the projected velocity. Okay. Suppose, another example. Suppose, dear students, a body is projected with a velocity of, say, that is, I will take 20 meter per second. What is the velocity of the body at the 3 by 4th of maximum height? 3 by 4th of maximum height. So 3 by 4th of maximum height. What is the velocity? Like this. This is, suppose this is 3 by 4th of maximum height. 3 by 4th of maximum height. So in this region, what is the velocity of the body? V is equal to, that is 2 by 10, that is 20 by 2 is nothing but 10 meter per second. Meter per second. So, dear students, please remember it. Whenever the body will be projected vertically upwards, velocity of the body gradually decreases, and finally becomes zero at maximum height. At maximum height. Okay. Okay, students. Now, next one. So, this is the very most important note. Very most important note. Note 1. So, dear students, whenever the body is projected vertically upwards at a maximum height, final velocity of the body zero, but acceleration not equal to zero. The acceleration produced by the body due to gravity. So, if acceleration equal to zero, if the velocity of the zero, velocity of the body at maximum height will be zero, acceleration not equal to zero. Acceleration is there due to gravity. So, the body possesses some acceleration. The direction of acceleration is radially inwards, that is towards the ground. Suppose a body is projected vertically upwards at a maximum height. This is the maximum height reached by the ball. So at final velocity will be acceleration. What is the direction of acceleration? That is towards the ground. This is the ground. This is the ground. Direction of acceleration. Direction of acceleration. Okay. Next. Note. Another note. So please remember it. Very most important one. Suppose a body is projected vertically upwards. Distance traveled by the body in first second. This is suppose after 1 second, it reaches by a distance of suppose 2 meter. A body is projected vertically upwards. Time taken by the body, that is distance traveled by the body in 1 second, is equal to the distance traveled by the body in the last second. That is in case of freely falling body. That is in case of downwards direction. That means a body is projected vertically upwards. Distance traveled by the body in first second is equal to the distance traveled by the body in last second. Both are equal. Ikkada first second lo manam throw cheyinalle, first second lo 2 meter distance travel chesthe last second lo adhe 1 second lo same 2 meter travel chestundi body. Body just touches the ground. Before 1 second it travel by distance of 2 meter. Same. Please remember it. Next one. Note 3. Suppose let us consider a body projected vertically upwards
projected vertically upwards like this, the distance traveled by the body in last second before reaches the maximum height, last second is equal to the distance traveled by the body in first second in downward direction like this. ఒక బాడీ మనం ప్రొజెక్ట్ చేసినప్పుడు పైకి మాక్సిమం హైట్ రీచ్ అవడానికి ముందు 1 సెకండ్ లో ఎంత డిస్టెన్స్ అయితే ట్రావెల్ చేస్తుందో అదే డిస్టెన్స్ అదే టైం ఇంటర్వెల్ లో సేమ్ 1 సెకండ్ లోనే సపోజ్ సేమ్ 1 సెకండ్ లోనే డౌన్వర్డ్ మోషన్ వచ్చేటప్పుడు ట్రావెల్ చేస్తుంది సేమ్ విషయం అంటే ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడికి ఎంత టైం పడుతుందో 1 సెకండ్ లో రిటర్న్ వచ్చేటప్పుడు కూడా సేమ్ టాప్ ఆఫ్ ద హైట్ ఇంకా ఆఫ్ కోర్స్ మాక్సిమం హైట్ ఇంకా 1 సెకండ్ లో సేమ్ డిస్టెన్స్ కవర్ చేస్తుంది ప్లీజ్ రిమెంబర్ ఇట్ వెరీ మోస్ట్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ బిట్స్ దట్ ఈస్ నోట్ 2 అండ్ నోట్ 3 ఓకే నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఈస్ సో వర్టికల్లీ ప్రొజెక్టెడ్ బాడీస్ ఓకే హైట్ ఆఫ్ ద టవర్ So that is application number 7. Height of the tower. How to calculate the height of the towers? So let us consider a tower of height S is equal to h. S is equal to h. Okay. A body is projected from the top of the tower. A body is projected from the top of the tower. Okay. So it reaches the ground after some time. That is after t seconds, it reaches the ground. Okay. So ఎప్పుడైతే మనం బాడీని ఇక్కడ నుంచి ప్రొజెక్ట్ చేసామో బాడీ ప్రొజెక్షన్ పాయింట్ ఇంకా సపోజ్ x1 డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ చేస్తుంది then it reaches the maximum height. So dear student, this is the both displacements are equal. ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ డిస్టెన్స్ ఉందో ఇక్కడ కూడా దిస్ ఈస్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ వన్. So this is the distance what? H. This is also H. But minus H. Okay. So whenever the body is projected from the top of the tower, after a time interval T, it reaches the ground. So first initially the body moving in upward direction, then after reaches the maximum, then return to the ground. Exactly the corresponding height like this. X1 is equal to minus x1. So ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ ఎంత డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ చేసిందో ఇక్కడ నుంచి కూడా సేమ్ అంతే డిస్టెన్స్ లో ట్రావెల్ చేసింది. అంటే దిస్ ఇస్ ఎక్స్ వన్, దిస్ ఇస్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ వన్. సో దెన్ దిస్ ఇస్ మైనస్ హెచ్, దిస్ ఇస్ ద హెచ్. ఇన్ దిస్ కేస్ నెట్ డిస్ప్లేస్మెంట్ of the body. Total displacement of the body. S is equal to what? X1. అది మొత్తం ఎంత డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ చేసింది? ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ ఎక్స్ వన్ వెళ్ళింది. మళ్ళీ దట్ ఈస్ ద సేమ్ డిస్టెన్స్, దట్ ఈస్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ వన్ అండ్ మైనస్ హెచ్. ఎక్స్ వన్ క్యాన్సిల్ అవ్వడం. S is equal to what? Minus h. In case of height of the towers, to find out the height of the towers, net displacement is equal to what? S is equal to minus h. Okay. Suppose, let us consider a body projected from the top of the tower. After some time, it reaches the ground. Calculate the height of the tower. Okay. How to calculate the height of the tower? So using the equation of motion, S is equal to ut plus half at square. S is equal to what? Minus h. So this is initial velocity ut minus half gt square, because a is equal to minus g. So initially body will be projected upwards. So a is equal to what? Minus g. So a is equal to minus g. This is the height or height of the tower. H is equal to minus to multiply chesthe half gt square minus ut. So this is the height of the tower. Deeniki minus vastundi, deeniki plus. Minus to multiply chesthe H is equal to
1 by 2 gt square minus 15. This is the height of the tower in case of vertically projected walls. This is the most important one. Next one. This is the height of the tower. Okay. Next. Next one. Okay. So another application. Suppose application number 8. A body is projected vertically upwards at the same instant of time, another body is released. At what time these two bodies are meet? So very most important application, dear students. So a body is projected vertically upwards, like this is the body projected vertically upwards with the velocity of u. Another body is released at the same instant of time. So in this case, initial velocity what? 0. At what time these two bodies are meet? Dear students, in this case, total distance traveled by the two bodies is nothing but what? S is equal to h. Ante kada? ఇది ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడికి కొంత డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ చేసింది, ఇది ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడికి కొంత డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ చేసిన తర్వాత రెండు మీట్ అయినదా. సో రెండు బాడీస్ ఓవరాల్ గా రెండు బాడీస్ ఎంత డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ చేసింది హెచ్ఏ కదా. సపోజ్ ఈ బాడీ ఎస్ వన్ ట్రావెల్ చేసింది, ఈ బాడీ ఎస్ టూ ట్రావెల్ చేసింది అనుకుంటుంది. సో టోటల్ డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ బై ద బాడీ, టోటల్ డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ traveled by the bodies is equal to height, is equal to height of the tower, height of the tower, height of the tower. Okay, total distance traveled by the bodies is equal to height of the tower. So height of the tower. Okay, so mane fine final chestna ikkada, at what time the two bodies are meet, at what time two bodies are meet, at what time two bodies are meet. Okay, so dear students, one body is projected vertically upwards, another body is of course released at the same instant of time. At what time two bodies are meet? Okay, total distance traveled by the two bodies is equal to height of the tower. That is, S1 plus S2 is equal to what? H. S1, suppose S1 is the freely falling body. So, freely falling body, that is, using the equation ut plus half gd square. Okay. That is, what equation? In this case, what equation is used? So, I will take one equation of motion, that is, S is equal to ut plus half gd square. So, initial velocity will be 0 at the case. So, half g t square plus projected body case. So, velocity is there. So, some velocity is there. So, ut minus half gd square. Minus sign means a is equal to minus in case of vertically projected bodies, that is equal to h. So dear student, half gds get cancelled out. Then h is equal to what? Ut. Time is equal to what? h by u. Okay, after what time the two bodies are meet? H by u. In the time tarvata rendu kuda meet. Suppose, for example, a body is projected vertically upwards with a velocity of, suppose example number 3, with a velocity of 20 meter per second, another body is released from the top of the tower of height 40 meters.
then what is the at what time they will meet? So t is equal to h is what 40, u is what 20, cancel out 2 seconds. After 2 seconds, the two bodies are meet. So very most important application. So at what time the two bodies are meet? Another one. At what time their velocities are equal? At what time their velocities are equal? At what time? Same continuation. At what time? Their velocities are equal. At what time? At what time their velocities are equal? V1 is equal to V2. So V1. So from freely falling body, there is initial velocity 0. So I will take the V is equal to U plus AT formula in case of freely falling bodies. V is equal to U plus AT, initial velocity 0, V is equal to what? GT. So V1 is equal to what? GT. That is equal to upward motions. For upward motion, V is equal to U minus GT. So that is U minus GT. A is equal to minus G for upward motion. Okay. So then, so you said this question is U is equal to 2GT. T is equal to what? U by 2g. At what time their velocities are equal? T is equal to U by 2g. This is a one more important bit. So, dear students, please remember it. A body is projected vertically upwards. At the same instant of time, another body is released from the top of the tower. At what time their two bodies are meet? And at what time their velocities are equal? So at what time the two bodies are meet, t is equal to h by u. At what time their velocities are equal, t is equal to u by 2g. Please remember it. Okay. Next another application is the very most important one, that is balloon. So a balloon is moving vertically upwards. Height of the balloon. Another application. Height of the balloon. How to calculate the height of the balloon? Okay. See, dear students, suppose let us consider a balloon moving vertically upwards with a velocity of u. So, with a velocity of u, like this, this is the ground. A balloon is moving vertically upwards. A stone is dropped from the balloon. Like this. This is the stone. This is the stone is dropped from the balloon. Initially, the velocity of the stone, the direction of velocity of the stone is upwards. Because of the balloon is moving upwards. Okay. So, initially, velocity of the balloon is equal to velocity of the stone. Both are equal. So, thereafter, the stone will be fall down on the earth surface. So in this case, how to calculate the height of the balloon? For upward motion, already we know A is equal to what? Minus G. Okay. So calculate the height of the balloon when the stone was dropped. First one, height of the balloon. When the stone was dropped. When the stone is dropped. So, if we take the
stone drop chesamo aa situation height of the balloon enta so height of the balloon when the stone is dropped from the balloon so then in this case same height of the tower formula so using the equation of motion s is equal to ut plus of gt square so s is equal to what h that is equal to of gt square minus ut this is the height of the balloon when the stone is dropped same formula that is to calculate the height of the tower formula height of the tower formula and also height of the balloon when the stone is dropped both are same formulas okay look at displacement anedi so that is first case lo upward undi second case lo downward undi kabatti net displacement is nothing but negative s is equal to minus h so using this equation a is equal to minus z then we will get h is equal to of g square minus ut this is the first one height of the balloon first one height of the balloon when the stone is dropped another case is there that is height of the balloon when the stone is reaches the ground when the stone is reaches the ground so what is the height of the balloon when the stone is reaches the ground stone ground reach ayinappudu height enta reach kaakunda just release chesinappudu height idi of g square minus ut height of the balloon when the stone is reaches the ground ground reach ayinadu for example in case of freely falling body case so initial velocity what zero so the body reaches the ground so using the equation s is equal to ut plus of gt square s is nothing but h initial velocity what zero initial velocity what zero half gt square half gt square okay so in this case h is equal to that is half gt square so this is the height of the balloon when the stone is reaches the ground so both two bits are very most important okay next one so next case this is also very most important another application so this is the I think last application in this session there is application number 10 so suppose let us consider three towers all three towers are equal heights okay so height is nothing but h is also h so suppose let us consider three towers this is the first tower this is second tower this is third tower A body is projected with a velocity of u from the first tower. It will reach the ground by a time interval of t1. Next, another body is projected vertically downwards with the same velocity. ये tower में क्या होगा? Body project चेसर ना है इंद्र velocity रहा? u1 velocity project chesaru upwards adi ground reach avadam ganthe isukundra t1 time isukundi next tower inka oka body ni project chesaru vertically downwards a body is projected vertically downwards with velocity of u it take a time interval of t2 time isukundi jagratha velala next another ball is dropped from the third tower that is freely falling body just release it initial velocity what zero so it reaches the ground by a time interval of t3 it reaches the ground by time is t3 by t3 time interval it reaches the ground okay so in this case what is the velocity first one we calculate the velocity of the projected body at what velocity the body or the ball or the stone is to the tail. How to calculate velocity of the body? First one is velocity. Velocity of the projected stone. Velocity of the projected stone. See, once again, a stone is projected vertically upwards with the velocity of u. In this case, it reaches the ground by time interval t1. Another stone is projected vertically downwards, directly vertically downwards. It reaches the ground by t2 time. Another one is, last one is freely falling body. A stone is just released. It reaches the ground by t3 time interval. Initial velocity what? Is equal to u. So what is the velocity of the stone? What is the velocity of the stone? Okay. See, dear students, please remember it. This is the upward motion. That, of course, that is the displacement x. This is the downward motion. That is also displacement minus x. They are simply cancelled. Okay. The difference of time t1 minus t2 is the net displacement travelled by the ball. Net displacement. And this gap lo adi ikkada ikkada difference in the gap e kada. ఆ గ్యాప్ లో ఇంకొక ది ఎక్స్ట్రా డిస్టెన్స్ అనేది ట్రావెల్ చేస్తుంది. ఓకే, టి వన్ మైనస్ టి టూ ఇస్ ద సో ఎక్స్ట్రా డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ బై ది బాడీ. ఎక్స్ట్రా డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ బై ద బాడీ, ట్రావెల్ బై ది బాడీ. సో ఆ గ్యాప్ లో ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ దీని ఇది ఒక ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ టెన్ మినిట్స్ లో వచ్చింది, ఇది టూ మినిట్స్ లో వచ్చేసింది. డిఫరెన్స్ ఎంత ఉంది? ఇది సపోజ్ 5 మినిట్స్, ఇది 2 మినిట్స్ లో గ్రౌండ్ రీచ్ అయింది. 5 మైనస్ 2 3 మినిట్స్ ఎక్స్ట్రా డిస్టెన్స్ కవర్ చేసింది, ఎక్స్ట్రా డిస్టెన్స్ ట్రావెల్ చేసింది. ఓకే, సో వెలాసిటీ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రొజెక్టెడ్ స్టోన్, సో t1 minus t2 ఇస్ ద ఎక్స్ట్రా డిస్టెన్స్. సో ఇన్ దిస్ టైం ఇంటర్వెల్ ద టైం ఇంటర్వెల్ ఆఫ్ t1 minus t2, ద టైం ఆఫ్ t1 minus t2, t1 minus t2, ద బాడీ ట్రావెల్ బై ఎక్స్ట్రా డిస్టెన్స్. Extra distance traveled by the body in a time interval of extra distance traveled by the body in a time of t1 minus t2. T1 minus t2. Okay. In this case, t1 minus t2 means the difference. T1 minus t2 is the time of flight. Time of flight of the body above the tower. T1 minus T2 means body ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడికి వచ్చే టైమే కదా. సింప్లీ బాడీ ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ రావడానికి ఎంత టైం పట్టింది? T1 minus T2 పట్టింది. ఆ గ్యాప్ లోనే పైకి వచ్చింది. T2 టైం మీద రిటర్న్ వచ్చేసింది, డైరెక్ట్ గా ఇక్కడ నుంచి గ్రౌండ్ రీచ్ అయింది. T1 టైం లో ఏమైంది? పైకి ఎందుకు కిందకి వచ్చింది? అంటే డిఫరెన్స్ T1 minus T2 లో ఇది ఇక్కడ నుంచి కరెక్ట్ గా ఇది ఇక్కడికి వచ్చేసింది. నేను ఇంకా B కి రీచింది T1 minus T2 టైం. ఇది ఏంటన్నా టోటల్ టైం Above the tower of the high, above the tower, time of flight. This is the time of flight. Time of flight means time taken by the body to reach the point B after projection. Please remember it. So T1 minus T2 is equal to time of flight. Above the tower. Please remember it. Above the tower. So time of flight above the tower. So T1 minus T2 equal to capital T. T1 minus T2 is equal to time of flight what? 2U by G. Already we know. So velocity of the projection what? U is equal to, in this case, on cross multiplication. So that is on cross multiplication 1 by 2 g t1 minus t2. This is the very most important one. Velocity of the projection, projected stone. Velocity of the projected stone. So u is equal to, at what velocity it will be projected? In case of first, from the first tower, this is the velocity of the stone projected from the first tower. Of course, second tower also velocity will be same. All heights are same. This is height of tower H also same. This is also same. Heights of three towers are same. So velocity of the stone, it will be projected. What velocity? U is equal to 1 by 2 g t1 minus t2. Okay, next one, time. At what time? So velocity of the projected, store value. Next, height. So we will calculate height. Height of the tower. Height of the towers. Dear students, all towers are equal height. How to calculate the height of the towers? How to calculate the height of the towers? So this is the velocity. So height of the tower, height of the tower, already we know S is equal to ut plus half at square. So S is nothing but h, ut, u, so velocity, what? 1 by 2 g t1 minus t2. So dear students, I will take first tower, height of the tower, in this case time, what is the time? T1. This is also T1. Okay, then S is equal to H. What is the value of U? 1 by 2, already we calculated. Now already we calculated value. 1 by 2 G T1 minus T2 into T1 plus 1 by 2 G T1 square. Okay. Now multiply, h is equal to 1 by 2 g t1 square minus 1 by 2 g t1 t2. Okay dear students, a is equal to what? In this case a is equal to minus g. A is equal to what? Minus g. Because in case of height, upward directions. So a is equal to, vertical projective what is? A is equal to minus g. That is minus 1 by 2 g t1 square. So half g t1 square, half g t1 square get cancelled out. Then h is equal, already we know h is equal to, of course this is also minus. So h is equal to minus half g t1 t2. So of course minus minus cancel out. Then height of the tower is equal to, in this case, g t1 t2. This is the height of the towers. Height of the towers, h is equal to half g t1 t2. Now next one is time taken by the body to reach the ground in case of third tower. From third tower, what is the time taken by the body to reach the ground? What is the time taken by the body to reach the ground? To reach the ground. So T3 time. So this is actually freely falling body, then using the equation. So S is equal to ut plus half at square. S is what? H. Initial velocity what? 0. That is half gt square. H, what is the value of h? Half g t1 t2 is equal to half gt square. Half g cancel out. T is equal to square root of t1 t2. This is the time factor. This is the time, that is simply this is T3. This is T3 is the time taken by the body to reach the ground in case of third tower. This is T3. Okay. So T3 is equal to square root of T1, T2. By using this formula to find out the time taken by the body to reach the ground in case of last tower. So T3 find out చేస్తే మనం T1 T2 కూడా ఈజీగా T1 minus T2 క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేయొచ్చు దీనిక. So మనం ఏ టైం ఇంటర్వెల్ అయినా మనం ఈ మెథడ్ లో మనం ఈజీగా క్యాలిక్యులేట్ చేయొచ్చు. This is the application number 10. Okay students, so in case of vertically projected bodies all applications are almost complete. Okay.